To install a recesset, simply place the selected unit directly against the substrate in the location desired. Keep in mind when selecting a location for placement, any framing members, piping, wall depths, etc. Mark around the perimeter of the unit and then place the unit aside. Enlarge the marked location by 1/2 inch to 5/8 of an inch on all four sides. Using the outside lines as your guide, cut the substrate out. You can now dry set the unit into the location to check for fit and final alignment. Make any minor adjustments if needed at this time. You may also wish to recess the mounting flange into your substrate. If this is your preference, while the unit is in place, mark around the perimeter of the flange. Remove the unit, set aside. Using an appropriate tool for your substrate material, you may now remove a small amount of substrate material to the thickness of the mounting flange. This can be done very easily using a hand grinder in most cementitious materials, such as wonderboard, or by using a utility knife and carefully peeling a layer or two of material in products such as Hardiebacker, DensShield, or Greenboard. Another method of smoothing the transition of the mounting flange is to feather your ceramic tile bonding material for the width of the trowel around the perimeter of the mounting flange after final placement of the unit. Place a continuous bead of caulk on the back of the mounting flange and insert the unit back into the final location. Secure the units in place using a hand screwdriver and the fasteners supplied with the unit. Wood blocking is not required in the installation of these units, but may be desired by you. An easy way to install this blocking is to use short pieces of 1x2 material about 6 inches in length, and prior to final setting of the unit, place the strips of wood flush to the edge of the cutout and put rust-resistant screws in each end to hold it in place. This will give sufficient backing for the mounting screws supplied with the recessets. Tile the units as desired using standard thinset or mastic appropriate for the installation of your finished material. You may wish to minimize some of the bottom slope. This can be done by thickening the bonding material at the leading edge of the recesset and tapering it to the back to obtain the desired slope. A floating shelf may also be installed with the recesset as an optional item. If so, this unit is designed to fit in the grout joint or a saw kerf if preferred. It mounts fully along the back of the unit and on both sides. Finished material is then bonded on both the top and bottom of the shelf using thinset or mastic to secure together. If the shelf sags slightly prior to grouting, you may find it necessary to prop the shelf from the bottom while the grout dries. After the grout cures, the prop may be removed.